I am going to be saying a little bit about the practitioners today. I need to say it because most of you are designers and you're probably being afflicted by the practitioners. They're giving you a hard time. I know that. And so I need to say something about it. When I started this journey on the Vastu Shastras, I started it in 75 or 76. So when I started that journey, nobody had heard of the Vastu Shastra. I went to Ganapati Sthapati, I studied with him. There was absolutely no mention of it. And then suddenly it became popular because there was a lot of money in it. Unfortunately, the basis for the, I would say, the practitioners in every nook and cranny today is because of the money. And much of what is being talked about as Vastu today comes under the purview of the astrologers. Most of the Vastu pundits in the market today are astrologers who have got onto the bandwagon. There is a little bit of astrology in Vastu, but it is not so heavily astrology influenced like they would like you to believe. Unfortunately, they have made it into that, which is a, I would say, a very sad thing. So there's a lot of fear being pushed, which I am totally against. Those of my students who are here will know one of my fundamental themes today is in India, we are losing our traditions very fast. Our culture is being eroded very fast. So we have to work together to safeguard it. Let us not get into this thing of creating fear. Because the moment you create fear, everything will be lost. People are going to stop believing in you. Your Vastu texts are not talking about you lose your eyesight if you have the door in the wrong place. They are not talking about it. They are talking about design. They are talking about energy. They are talking about the relationship between the human being and the natural system. Don't let us lose all that by giving silly little formulae about changing the doorway. Those have all come in the last 20 years. They are not the original. The original is the oldest living system of design and energy, analysis of energy. And that is the larger frame you must hold in your mind. All the little things you can also do. I have no issues about you telling people to change their doorway. But don't do it without understanding what is the basis on which it is standing. This knowledge. Understand what they mean by proportion. Understand about what they mean by harmony. Because those are the critical factors of the Vastu Shastra. Okay? Vastu is talking about life systems. Just like yoga is. Like yoga today is being seen as asana. Asana is one part of yoga. The fact is, ours is an oral transference tradition. All thought and knowledge went through the word. It was held by people through the spoken word. Written material came much later. So even today the Vedas are actually learned through the spoken word. And it is safeguarded through the spoken word. So when the spoken word has been badly fragmented, people have lost their knowledge base. So if somebody comes in and frightens you, you get frightened. Because you have no background knowledge to tell you, hey, this guy is pushing me because he wants to make money out of me. You're not able to figure that out. Oh, just in case I don't want this to happen, let me try that also. This is how people are falling into the trap. So today, it is very important that we all work together. This is not me against somebody. I'm trying to create a holistic way of looking at the world. And in this, we need everybody's assistance. You know something more than me, I'm quite willing to learn from you. But first, learn the larger frame before you get caught with fear-mongering. Try to say it in such a way it helps people to become more powerful than to become more scared. Because today, empowerment is very important. The average Indian is a very frightened, very nervous person with very little self-confidence, with very little sense of self-worth. In the global space, they are constantly at the beck and call of the white man still. Right? So if you want to build back the confidence and the pride of the average Indian, you have to work with empowering rather than frightening. Okay? Are you with me on this?
Okay.
That is the only way you can honor the ancestors. Because they've done a great job. They have been so sensitive to the environment. And they have put it all together in the most precise way that is possible. Nobody can be more precise than some of the sutras that you can find in our traditional texts. So perfect. You can't say it in any other way. So today it is very important that we leave aside all that has been told to us, put it aside and learn this newly, because it's a different perspective.
It has been a great honor to meet Shashikala ma'am. She has put a lot of effort into preserving this traditional wisdom and passing down the generation.
I ended up here with the question, what is the purpose of life? So this journey has been very important in this phase of my life. I was guided by my professor to this place, to ma'am actually, and to learn this traditional knowledge system from an authentic source was very much important for me.
And Shashikala ma'am is tremendously inspiring woman. The dynamism that she holds, it just spreads around. And the space that they've created here, Rithambara, how they call it as Vasudeva Kutumbakam, it's a very genuine ideal that they have, and we are all very happy to be a part of this sharing.
I think every time I come here, I connect with people who are on similar journeys, and I know that they're connections for life, and we come together to do meaningful work and to support each other in our growth, and this is something that I feel needs to grow and needs to expand. It's a very authentic space. Theme of exploration in Vastu workshops is creating space within ourselves and also space outside.